Let us understand question 6 of exercise 4.1. In the given question, it is said that consider the following figures of line MN. Say whether the following statements are true or false in the context of the given figure. Let us see the first one. In the first statement, they are saying that Q, M, O, N, P are points on line MN. M and N. Let me first draw. Suppose, children, take this point is M. I am excluding everything. Only we will first consider a point MN. Now see, what is the question? The question is that if it is line MN, as you see in the figure, can you say that Q, M, O, N, P, they lie on this line or they are the points on line MN? Let us check. See, it is a line. It can extend endlessly from both the directions. Correct? So, see here, already O is in between M and N. So, this we are sure of that O is a point of MN. But what about Q and P? So, this is a line. I can extend. If I extend, so here I can place one point and make it Q. And here also I can extend and place one point P. Correct? So, your answer will be yes. And you, after writing yes, you will draw this. First, you will draw this line M and N only. Like this, then you will show that you are extending. So, when you extend again, you can place points on this line MN. So, here it is, yes. Now, they are saying, same way MON are points on line segment. That is also correct. We have just now discussed that MON, these three points are on MN. Yes, if it is 3, if it is 5, all the two statements are correct. Now think of the third statement. In the third statement, it is said that M and N are end points of line segment MN. That means, let us draw, they are saying that M and N, they are the end points of line. It is line segment. See here. It is M, then it is given O, and then it is N. Correct? So, what is a line segment which has a definite length? The starting point is M. Check here. Starting point is M and destination point is N. Because no direction is given. If you start from there, then this will become your starting point. In between whatever points are there, if there are 10 points also, apart from O, you have R, S, then also the end points will remain M and N. So, for the third one also, that is also true. You have asked right on true, right? True. Now, check the D one. O and N are the end points of OP. This time they are saying instead of MN, it is O and P, end points. No, on a line segment OP. Where is OP? This is OP. Let us draw OP first. Here it is O. We are just drawing the line segments. And see, this is P. In between, what do you have? N. This much is clear. On line segment OP. O and N are the end points. N is not the end point. It is in between. Correct? So, for D, your answer will be false. But you have to draw and show. Draw a rough figure and show N is not the end point. That is why this statement comes to be true. Now, see the sixth one. M is point on ray OP. Let us see where is OP. OP. Draw again. O and P. It is said about a ray. Yes, they are talking about ray. So, this time we will draw OP. M is the point on ray OP. Which point is in between, children, here? Only one point is there, that is N. And in this question, they are saying M is the point on ray OP. No, we do not have M. So, our F is also false. We forgot E? Okay, let us discuss E. M is one of the endpoints of line segment QO. So, for E, we are talking about QO. So, let us first draw that Q till O. Line segment, they are saying. So, we will draw line segment. That is this part. Q, then we have M and we will stop at O. Yeah, O. Now, see. E1. M is the end point on the line segment QO. Do you think M is the end point? No. Again here, the answer for E is also false. Why? Because it is a point in between Q and O. So, you will write down because, you can give it the justification also, because M is not the end point, whereas it is in between line segment QO. So, for previous questions also, see, it is true or false. I have drawn the figure and explained you. You also draw and you can write down what I have explained orally, that you can write down, because if it is true, let it be. If it is false, why it is false, that I have shown you with the figure, you can write down the justification. You can write down the reason why it is false. Okay. Now, let us move to your G question. What is the G part? It is given ray OP is different from ray QP. Let us see. First, I will, where is QP? Draw. They are talking about QP ray. So, this is Q and this is P, and they are also talking about QP and OP. Let us see where is O. So here it will start with O and here it is P. So in between OP, see, only one point is there, that is N. And in between QP, you have M, you have O, you have N. Now then, ray OP is different from ray QP. Is it same? They are not same. Number of points here. See, it is different. Here we have only two points. N, yes. Here I have N, only one point in between. And there are so many points in between the line. So, for the G1, it is G. Yes, it is different. Correct. It is different. That is true. Now, the H1. OP is same as OM. Where is OM? Let us draw OM. This is your O. See, OM. That means here you have O and you have M here. Now check. OP is same as OM. Are they two same, children? No. Here also they are not same. See, they are also different. Okay. The next one, I. I hope it is clear. Why? Because OP and OM. Ray is, first thing, see the direction of the ray. They are not same. They are moving in opposite direction. First difference is this only. So, you can say it is not same. And see the number of point. It is simply OM. Here you have one more point. Now, same way, I. Ray OM is not opposite to ray OP. OM is not opposite. Just now we have discussed. The I1 also, you will draw the same figure, same for this one also, what you have drawn for H. Same thing. See, they are saying OM and OP. They are in different, they are not in opposite direction. No, they are moving in opposite direction. See, OP is moving towards the right. And OM is moving towards the left. Those, that is why this is also false. Now, N is the initial point of NP and NM line segment. Let us see NM, that is here N, then you have M, and here you have P. Line segment NM and NP also. So let us see N and P. They are talking about N and P. What they are saying? For line segment NM and NP, N is the initial point. Yes, children, see, it is the initial point, starting from point. Because when we say NP, that means we are starting from N. If we want to start from P, then it will be PN, correct? So, here it is starting from N, NP, and for NM also, see, NM. So, NM is starting from again N. So, is that true? Yes. That is also yes, or it is true. You will show by this. See, it is starting from N. This is my initial point, starting point, and here also this is our starting point. So this was our question number 6. Now I hope you have understood all the questions. So we have completed exercise 4.1, and next in the next session we are going to start with exercise 4.2. Complete your work. God bless you.